You see, the problem with you Catholics is that many of you say the rosary as if it is duty. Stop saying rosary as Catholics. Discover the power of the rosary and say it. Many of you, once the rosary for you is like a punishment. Some of you think that if you don't say the rosary, the Pope will flog you. And many priests have used fear to make you say the rosary, as if saying the rosary is what makes you Catholic. No, saying the rosary is not what makes you Catholic. You are saying the rosary because there are graces in it. The church asks you to say the rosary because the church knows the efficacy of that prayer. Forget that we don't give testimonies like most people do. We don't do advertised testimonies. Does not mean it's not happening. Say your rosary. Enjoy saying the rosary. I do not say the rosary because I'm a Catholic. No, I say the rosary because I know how beneficial it has been. Genesis chapter 3, God said to the serpent, I shall put enmity between you and the woman, between her seed and yours. He will crush your head and you bruise her heel. Between you and the woman. Galatians 4:47, when the time comes, God sent his son, born of a woman, born a subject of the law, to redeem the subjects of the law, so that we might become the adopted sons. We were adopted, and that adoption took place through the birth of the Lord Jesus Christ, his mother Mary. That was why he handed her to John and handed John to her. That was an exchange for all Christians that many of us don't know. I will put enmity between you and the woman, between her seed and your offspring. Say your rosary, you dey walk. I'm not telling you say it as a Catholic. If you don't say your rosary as a Catholic, I cannot flog you. Say it with faith. Stop saying it as Catholics. Well, even, the way some of you even say the rosary itself, like I say, as if it is a duty you must do. So some of you just say carelessly. In the market, somebody is, Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Madam, you get a goosey, yes. Blessed are you among women, blessed is the fruit of thy womb. How much? 20 naira. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us. Can you say 15 naira? Amba. And now, and at the hour of our death, amen. Because he wants to rush and finish the rosary so that it will be that he or she has said the rosary. That's not how to say the rosary. Do you know how many miracles people have experienced through Mary? There is one that is told. I think I've told you this one before. One priest visited the family, the wife and the husband, they were complaining, no child, I think after 5 years. And the priest said to them, okay, just go to Lourdes. Lourdes is a pilgrimage place in, is it Portugal or France? Abi Spain? France, ba? Uh-huh. People go there. There is a shrine of the Blessed Virgin Mary there. He said, go there, light a candle, that our mother Mary will intercede for you. The man went, lit a candle, came back. I think after 2 years, maybe 3 years, the priest came back again. I think after 2 years, he came back. And he saw, I think it should be 3 or 4 years, he saw some children playing outside. He discovered he was one of the children of the man. I mean, he saw a child playing. He said, maybe two children are bad. He said, where is your dad? He said, my dad has gone back to Lourdes. He said, to go and do what? He said, he has gone to quench the candle. Why? Under 4 years, the man don't get triplets. He doesn't want anymore. It may be a dramatic story, but it's happened. I know somebody in area 3 here who got miracle of healing from breast cancer just by saying rosary at the Blessed Sacrament. Say your rosary. And what is even the prayer of the rosary that many of people are? What is it in the Bible? There is no prayer that is more biblical than the rosary. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Where is that one coming from? Who talk am? No, the angel. Now, angel Gabriel now. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. Blessed are you. I know. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with you. That's from angel Gabriel. Then, blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Elizabeth. The only one we added there is Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us. I'm not going to tell Mary, may she pray for me. Don't you tell your fellow human being to pray for you. So you can tell another human being like you, who is still suffering on earth, to pray for you. But I can't tell somebody who I know is in heaven to pray for me. The Katina, who is she that coming forth as the morning rising, fair as the moon? It's in the Bible, Song of Songs. The one that Mary prayed today, Magnificat. My soul now glorifies the Lord who is. Where is he coming from? That's what Mary said today. Do you know Mary is not the first to say that prayer? Who is the first? Hannah, 1 Samuel. The mysteries, joyful mysteries, all about Jesus. First joyful mystery is what? Annunciation. Who do annunciation? It not be Angel Gabriel. Second joyful mystery, visitation, which you have read today. Third one, nativity, birth of Jesus. Fourth one, presentation in the temple. Is it not in the gospel? And then the fifth one. Eh? It's not in, is it not in the gospel? Sorrowful mystery. They know the gospel. Mystery of light. They know the gospel. Then the glorious mystery is the fourth one we are celebrating today. Let me tell somebody, say your rosary, say your rosary. Say it with faith. Stop saying it as a Catholic. Say your rosary with faith. That thing is umbo, abambo. Did you see the Bible said in Revelation today that as soon as a woman appeared who was about to give birth, the devil came, was waiting to eat the child. All of this in the description of Jesus. When Jesus was born, who was about to kill him? Was he not Herod? That was the devil coming through was Herod to kill him. He said the child was taken and the woman was meant to escape to heaven. That means Mary defeated the devil on earth and even at the celestial distance. You are a priestly Christian. When you carry this ark, you too will defeat the devil. If there's anything happening in your family, say the rosary. Quote me, say it with faith. And for our non-Catholic brothers, I can understand. I can understand. You know. But what I know that nobody can do is to tell me that it is not in the Bible. Nobody can do that. You may question my devotion, my belief in the assumption or any other dogma of Mary, based on your own logic. But if you bring it in the Bible, come, let's sit down. I will show you as it is now. We even show you more. You cannot use the Bible as evidence. And I hope you know, as a Catholic, our faith is based on sacred scripture and tradition. We keep making allusion to that sacred scripture and tradition. So, my dear brothers, Mary was assumed to heaven. It means that after everything is done, God took her. So, she won here on earth and she won heaven. I pray for you today. May you be victorious here on earth and may you be victorious up to heaven. In the name of Jesus Christ, every dragon that is seeking to eat you or eat your produce or your fruit shall not succeed in the name of Jesus Christ. God will snatch you from the mouth of the killer, the devourer, and the destroyer in the name of Jesus Christ. I say you will make it in the name of Jesus Christ. And at the end, when our life here is ended, I pray for all of us here that we enjoy a fruitful, long, healthy, happy, and successful life. And at the end, may we also converge in heaven. In fact, I have told God that in heaven, I want to see St. John Mary Vianney. We shall continue our church there. Abi? Eh? Can I hear a bigger amen? Amen.
To watch full videos and get notifications for new ones, please subscribe to my YouTube channel. God bless you.
Sign up with the largest community of Catholics online. Meet new friends, chat, post pictures and videos, make and receive audios and video calls, interact with lots of priests and religions. Download the app from Google Play Store.